You look to the book of Luke in terms of this development of the holistic human experience. Tie that scripture together for us.
Yeah, I mean, I think obviously virtually every Christian believes that we are more than physical, and they certainly recognize that we are physical. But oftentimes we think of ourselves as just physical, and maybe one day we'll just kind of poof into the clouds or something. But Luke says, Luke 2:52 talks about Jesus growing, and it says Jesus grew in wisdom and strength and in favor with God and man. And I see that really as kind of the four aspects of a human. We're spiritual, we're mental, we're physical, and we're relational. We even see that in Mark where Jesus is quoting Deuteronomy and he talks about the physical and non-physical aspects of our being. He says, you need to, you know, focus on God with all of that, and you need to love your neighbor as yourself, because that's the relationship part. So when a person is struggling with a mental health problem or a family is trying to deal with a person with a mental health problem, they're affected at all those levels, spiritual, mental, physical, and relational. And the church has an opportunity to engage them at all of those levels and assist them at all those levels, which is something the secular community simply cannot do.
Yeah, it's so true. You know, this may be the most interesting of the questions I've been able to ask. And when you look at scripture, so often we'll say, you know, there's a lot of dysfunction in the Bible in human beings. When you look at scripture as a neuroscientist and you look at some of the characters there, what do you see? What diagnosis do you make?
You know, it's a hard thing, again, to look back through time and through culture and see that. But if you just come at the Bible with, you kind of take your spiritual blinders off for a moment, the Bible is full of incredible observations and incredible observations of behavior, the good and the bad,
right?
As people like to say, the warts, you know. And what you see are mental health symptoms throughout the entire Bible, which you can clump together and kind of say, well, if this person was alive today and showed these symptoms, they would be looked at in this context or that context. So for instance, you look at someone like King David, who we have mythologized into almost a kind of a Greek mythological character. He is a disaster throughout his life. Most of his Psalms are Psalms of lament. He struggles with depression. He shows all the signs of depression. I mean, there's no person in the Bible that we have more information about than that individual. His writings are there. Historical documents about him are there. Discussions from other people about him are there. And clearly the man struggles with depression. Yet he is a man after God's own heart. And in the midst of that depression, in a time in which there was no treatment, he desperately seeks out God. And God comes close. And so I think, you know, we look at someone like King David, and it's a great opportunity to give someone with depression a lot of encouragement to say, look, even this great man of God struggled, or Job with trauma, or Samson with antisocial behavior. He was a horrible, horrible individual.
Samson, that's a good...
He's a horrible... Or Gomer with struggling with the symptoms of what looked like a, kind of a borderline personality disorder. There's a lot of individuals throughout, and I'm not saying they had those disorders. I'm saying that the symptoms or the descriptions of the behaviors and thoughts they have are there. But if nothing else, look at Jesus himself. On four different occasions, Jesus is thought to be mad. People consider him insane or mad. The Pharisees do. And at that time, madness and demonic possession were equated. And so his family is said, come get him. He's insane. He has a demon. So our Savior, just like Hebrews tells us, understands what it is to have the stigma of mental illness thrown upon you.
Huh.
And he can be an encouragement and an empowerment during that recovery.